This video was taken 3 months ago. It has taken us that long to get our room completely done, but this is the room decor shopping vlog. We started this journey off at Walmart, getting the essentials, and then we went to Home Goods for some accessories. We were looking for a desk chair and some little things to make our room a little bit more homey, a little mini trash can, and we got some LED lights as well. These lights are for underneath our bed instead of on the walls. After Home Goods, we went to IKEA. IKEA brings back memories of when I used to go here as a kid and play in the ball pit. Anyways, that has nothing to do with this video. We were looking for a new desk, and this was the shoe wall idea that we had, but they didn't have it in white, so we ended up just buying individual blocks, and we built our own desk and got a lot of other furniture. The full room tour is finally up on YouTube.
One thing in your house you need to get rid of. Something you will never get rid of. One thing you never use. One thing you use all the time. One thing that is brand new. One thing that is old. Something you got as a gift. Something you want to pass down to your kids. Something you thrifted. The cheapest thing you own. The most expensive thing you own.
Here's a look at how we installed new flooring in our daughter's room for under 180 bucks. First, we ripped out all the old slime-covered carpet and the tack strips using a pry bar and a hammer. And the builders had also put the tacking on top of the threshold, so I had to cut the vinyl back straight and scrape all the glue, residual paint, and texture that was left over on the concrete. I used this flexible floor patch from DAP to fill in all the nail holes from the tack strips. It dries fast, and then you can just scrape it to make sure that it's nice and level. And to prep the floors, I mopped it really, really good. And then I used a self-stick tile primer, which is a latex coating that you apply to the concrete to make sure the tiles stick firmly. Then I found the center of the room and laid a chalk line down so that I could start laying my tile out from the center of the room from that line. We have vinyl flooring throughout our house and love the durability, but $1 a square foot for this peel and stick, we just couldn't pass that up. And the install was so easy, Emily actually did most of it. So make sure you're following us for the final room reveal. You're not gonna wanna miss it.
Please don't be ugly. Please don't be ugly. Please. Please. Oh my God! The tears have to with her. Like a river. Like a river. Shut off my head and run me like a river.
She thinks it's special, but it's all reused. That was our place. I found it first. I made the jokes you tell them.
I'm going to tell you about interior design mistakes I don't want you to make in your own home. First up, try to keep your kitchen counters as clear as possible. All of this honestly just looks cluttered, even though this is a picture trying to sell an organizer. Most designers are going to give you this advice, but don't buy an entire matching bedroom set like this. Honestly, it looks very 80s and 90s going to a big box store. It's going to really cheapen your house if you have curtains that don't go all the way down to the floor. This just looks silly. Honestly, try to get your curtains as close to the ceiling and then just kissing the bottom of the floor to get a very high-end look. And lastly, rugs that are too small for a living space don't look good. Go bigger. Three things that are making your house look cheap. First up, we have any form of cord clutter. Look at the TV cords in the top picture and how this could be a really cute little setup, but the cords are just ruining it. Where Young House Love did this below, and honestly, it's like cute, kitschy, kid theme, and you don't have any cords running through the walls. Now, some of you might be like, well, I'm a renter. I can't do that. Still do it. You can do two things. One, either your landlord's going to be happy you made this improvement because now other tenants can do this, or two, you can fix the hole really easily. Okay, parents, don't be mad at me, but this kid clutter on your fridge is making it look really cheap. If you're having guests over, just clean it up and get everything off if you want it to look higher end. If not, do you, boo. Lastly, general mess and clutter. If everything has a place and you use a minimalistic design, it's gonna look so much more luxurious.
So at 19, I've decided that being an adult is overrated and I am painting my room pink and turning it into a fairy forest. So the first step is to get everything off my walls and decide what I wanna keep or donate and just like clean up the vibe. But like honestly, I think I'm gonna shove everything in my closet. And the next step is to prep my walls to paint it pink, like for part two.
It's really not that bad. It just needs a little shaping. To the salon!
I love